What's going on, guys? Welcome to Everything Always. My name's Michael Roman, aka All Fires, and Marvel Studios finally dropped the official teaser trailer for Thor, Love, and Thunder this morning. And there are so many Easter eggs packed into this thing. We're going to go frame by frame, scene by scene. I'm going to try to break it all down for you guys. We got a first look at the Guardians in a long, long time. What's going on with our Thor? A first look at the mighty Thor, Jane Foster, right at the end of the trailer. And while they didn't show Gore the God Butcher just yet, there are a ton of Easter eggs that tease is coming. We're breaking down everything in this brand new official teaser trailer for Thor 4, Love, and Thunder. First, if you could, consider hitting the subscribe button. We do daily Marvel content at the channel, and that's all we do. Everything from official Easter egg breakdowns and trailer reviews like we're doing today to the industry insider scoop and everything in between. So if that sort of thing's for you, hit the subscribe button, leave a comment down below. And if you want, stick around to the end of the video. We'll get into all the giveaway stuff again there.
These hands were once used for battle. Now they're but humble tools for peace. I need to figure out exactly who I am.
Okay, so this thing hits the ground running, pun totally intended, and does not stop. In the very first frame of the trailer, we see the classic Thor costume to be perfectly matched up with the classic Loki costume. They are really going all out in Marvel Phase 4 to make sure they touch on every classic Marvel costume from the old school, or what some people call the golden age of comics, as much as they can. Now, someone should have told Thor and reminded him as he's giving this totally tongue-in-cheek sentimental breakdown, because if you know anything about Taika Waititi movies, this is definitely all meant to be set up for some sort of punchline. Someone should have reminded him that the handle to Stormbreaker was actually made out of the arm of Groot. James Gunn made it a point in two parts of the Guardians of the Galaxy first film to make sure we know that when you plant part of a Groot, that it literally grows into another Groot. That's why the Collector asks Groot's permission to do so, and that's why Rocket does it after Groot sacrifices himself to save the entire team. We see him planting Stormbreaker. We know he'll be using it later in the film, but we also know this film is already set to feature multiple versions of Thor. That's what we're doing now in this Phase 4 multiverse era. It's variants, and we already saw two in this trailer. Chris Hemsworth, Thor, and then, of course, Natalie Portman retaining her role as Jane Foster, becoming the Mighty Thor. And in a film that's rumored to feature multiple versions of Thor, if you're wondering if there's a Thor version of Groot, there actually is. I'm not saying that's what's going to come of this, but we also know they're about to launch a Disney Plus I Am Groot series that seems to feature a young Groot. I'm not sure if it's a continuation of this, but our Groot has already turned into teenage Groot by the time this film drops. Just keep all that in mind as we see him plant his Stormbreaker, and who knows what may come by the end of this film.
I want to choose my own path. Live in the moment. Superheroing days are over.
Ah, the sounds of Guns N' Roses, Sweet Child of Mine. I can smell the copyright claim from here. There's almost no way this video is ever getting monetized. Of course, that song paired with a quick montage of how he got in shape after last we saw him in Avengers Endgame is striking that nostalgic 80s montage feel that's right in the wheelhouse for Taika Waititi. Speaking of which, this next scene in the trailer, even without dialogue, is so funny. The more I watched it in film editing, I came back to bring this up, but you can clearly see the dialogue playing out here, just like that scene from Forrest Gump where he's running across America, and then somewhere in the middle of the country, he just decides that and exclaims, just like that, his running days are over. And you can see it play out in the scene. It looks like they're about to all fight a battle, and he just decides, no, right there, that he's done. It's what he's saying in the overdub for his voice there. His battle days are behind him. He wants to find out who he is. And it even says in the trailer that not every god has a plan. Poignant reminder that indeed Thor is a god, and when Gore comes calling for them all, which we're going to touch on again here in just a second in this trailer breakdown, Thor will be among the hit list. Now, before we move on, two really important things you can notice in this last frame. First of all, it looks like the Ravagers, the Guardians of the Galaxy, are dropping Korg and Thor back off on Sakaar. You can tell pretty clearly that's the planet from the frame. Also, take a good look at Korg. Nice pants. But more specifically, it looks like he's been visiting the new Asgard armory. You can just tell from his threads. Look at his leather-bound chest piece with the enormous wool collar. And of course, the ram belt buckle, which calls the imagery of Thor's two goats, which we happen to see in the very next frame. Toothgnasher and Toothgrinder, they're mystical goats of Thor that pull his chariot. And that is an analog from actual Norse mythology, where that Thor has two goats as well, names that I absolutely can't pronounce, so I'm not going to try. But I want to zoom in real quickly on this frame. This is very obviously New Asgard as we've seen it before, except now on the docks, it looks as though they've built a palace. Speaking of which, that most certainly looks like Valkyrie on the back of that chariot and not Thor. Okay, there's so much going on here. She's leaving what looks like New Asgard, but this is very clearly not New Asgard. We're going to speculate on where that is later. Thor's out on adventures, kissing pirates, and it says in the overlay that not every god has a plan. We also see him just emitting Bifrost at will, and also after breaking down Legends action figures and other toy promos for the last, 3 months. It's really nice to get a first look at his armor, and it looks absolutely incredible. I know there were some people who were like, I'm not sure about that. Take a good look at it. It looks amazing. Speaking of which, the next couple of frames, I'm sure, show us the interior of where we saw a couple of frames ago, where they were approaching something that looked like Hanging Gardens. This is definitely Zeus, played by none other than Russell Crowe, even though we got a couple of shots of his back. I also want to mention that immediately noticing the gold coloring on, I would say, whatever his special ability here is, matches up perfectly with the Eternals, putting him sort of in that celestial god range for his power set. Marvel, yet again, color coding all of their magic and superhero abilities for no other reason than, I think, in order for us to keep track of them during big battles.
Remember what I told you. You ever feel lost? Just look into the eyes of the people that you love. Not me.
What? Just listening.
So by a couple of frames we've seen, it's pretty obvious that Thor and Korg at some point go on some sort of vision quest. He's trying to figure something out. So it's also important to note here that it looks like the World UN Council has tried to roll Valkyrie into whatever's going on. This scene is hilarious, with Thor divulging that he loves Peter Quill by trying to stare into his eyes. Again, this really looks like Sakaar in the background, but I don't want to claim that it is, because we're going to be all over the galaxy during this film. It's hard to tell. There could be more than one planet like that. But then, of course, we get the major reveal for this first teaser. Natalie Portman as the Mighty Thor. Lady Thor Jane Foster, she's wielding Mjolnir that looks like it's been reconstructed from the shards of the broken Mjolnir we last saw when Hela grabbed it. Again, right there on those same cliffs that New Asgard exists, but there is no context at all for what's going on in this scene or this reveal. And of course, as I mentioned at the very beginning of this video, absolutely zero in the way of showing Gore the God Butcher. But what they are showing us, the common theme throughout this, is that it's a discovery story for Thor now, for this next chapter of who he's meant to be. And no matter what, he's still a god. I'm guessing that's why he tries to convene with Zeus and some of the other gods like him. Maybe he finds that that's not for him. I really like about this film the most, though, is that everybody looks like they've taken huge power upgrades. And you know, I don't mind an antagonist every now and again coming up against a overpowered superhero instead of being down and out completely, like we saw at the end of Infinity War. I am super excited for this film, and I think they really downplayed how much the multiverse and variants of Thor are going to come into play. But mark my words, him planting Stormbreaker to me is the biggest foreshadowing for someone like Groot Thor to show up at some point in this film in the pantheon of Thors. There is a Thor Corps, and we'll talk about that in the upcoming week. Absolutely zero mention, though, of one fan favorite character in Beta Ray Bill that makes you really wonder if there was any way Kevin Feige, Marvel Studios, and Taika Waititi found a way to work him into the story. And my hopes are, well, I should say pretty high, but tempered, given that it really doesn't feel like we would need him. There's so much already going on. But guys, let me know all your thoughts down below. And of course, there's probably a lot of Easter eggs in here I didn't catch on the first watch through. You guys may have caught. Make sure to leave those down in the comments. We will be breaking it down. And of course, a ton of Thor theories in the coming week. And also, Doctor Strange in the Multiverse of Madness just posted a brand new trailer while I was doing this, so watch out for a breakdown of any new footage later at the channel. Speaking of which, let's get into the giveaway stuff before I let you go. We are still giving away PlayStation 5s all the way up to a million subscribers, and we are closing in on the next giveaway. We're doing it every 20,000 all the way up to a million. If you want to be entered to win or for any of the other giveaways here at the channel, all the same rules will always apply. All you have to do, hit the subscribe button, then leave a comment down below. Because it's truly random, the more videos you comment on, the better chance you have of winning. All winners will be announced at the end of videos, the same way we're doing here. The best way to keep up with the content has always been to hit the notification bell with all notifications turned on. And as always, if you like today's video, I'd appreciate it if you'd hit the like button. My name's Michael Roman. You can find me in a couple of places, Instagram and Twitter at IamFires. And you can also find me on every platform you listen to original music on, YouTube, Spotify, Amazon, Apple, iTunes, anywhere, under the name All Fires. And while I sincerely appreciate you checking my music out, just pushing it out into the algorithm, even if you just want to support me as a content creator and you're not really feeling the tunes, it still helps them get out there. I'd appreciate that. I really appreciate you checking this channel out, though. Stick around. We'll be posting again real soon.